Paris had tramways all over the place until the 1950s and 1960s when they were taken out to make room for buses.
Now,
and here we are, half a century later, putting in new tramways. This is the first of a series of tramways that are in the first instance going to circle the entire city of Paris. The present line circles about one third of it. What has happened has been that the real estate values have skyrocketed.
We're at a tram stop, and right there you have a whole bunch of Villiers. So the Villiers system is in a way the other half of the tram system. All of these bits and pieces work together.
What happens is that the light is green, and it means that this bicycle is available. So what I do is I check the tires, I check the chain to make sure that it's in order, I check the brakes, so I've got a vehicle that's in good order, and all I have to do is push this button, put on my card, pull it out, and I'm ready to go.
How do you find the develop cycles?
I really like them. I used to have a bike when I lived in Paris, and so it was really nice to come back and to be able to have a bike here. So.
Do they have a system like this in London?
No, unfortunately not.
Do you think it would be useful?
It's a very different city. It's much bigger, so I'm not sure if it would work quite as well, but it would be really good. I would like it a lot.
And so when you were living here in Paris, the develop didn't exist?
No.
So this is something new to you?
Yes.
And you think it's made a difference to the quality of the city?
I think it's really, really good, and I think it's really good for tourists as a way to kind of discover the city. You see much more on a bike, so no, I think it's really changed Paris.
Well, I'm back. I've been all over Paris. So now I have to check in my bicycle. So I do this, but I get next to the station, and it's a little bit tricky the first time. You just line it up, and you jam it in the best you can see. There you go, it turns yellow, and then it will turn green, hopefully. And when that happens, it means that the bicycle has been placed back. I'm no longer responsible for what happens to it.
C'est donc le bateau Vélib, où les JC Deco, en fait, organisent la maintenance des vélos Vélib dans ce bateau. Et ce bateau donc se déplace pour reprendre les vélos qui ont besoin d'être réparés ou maintenus.
Et donc au total, combien de stations Vélib sont planifiées dans...
Alors là, on a planifié 1451 stations.
We already have in place 1,461 Vélib stations and are planning for 300 more during the summer of 2008, bringing it to a total of 1,761. The aim is to develop the service to respond to the demand and continue to expand the network of cyclopaths. For Vélib stations outside of Paris, it's necessary to have paths that link the suburbs to the center. This is a link to your goal of regional solidarity. Absolutely. Paris is not alone. There are 2.1 million residents in Paris, but it sits in a region of 12 million people. We have to consider the transportation for the larger region and not only the nucleus of Paris.
Accommodates something like 80 or 90 passengers.
An average car in Paris has 1.1 to 1.2 people in it, so it's the equivalent of 60 or 70 cars.
Of transportation. One system is pavements, sidewalk, so very large. This is cycle pass. This is the bus lane, so you can see some mobilia coming and also some tourist bus. And you have also the four lanes road for the cars.
Les quartiers verts à Paris, parce que est-ce que c'était qu'il n'y avait pas assez de verdure à Paris qu'on a pensé de ça, ou c'était quoi le concept?
Alors, en fait,
in the smaller streets, we could not have divided lanes. So in the interior areas between the larger roads, there are smaller streets where we limited the speed to 30 km per hour to slow down the circulation. We also widened the pavements, for example, in front of schools. We protected pedestrian paths or elevated them. And when we could, we planted some trees and created smaller public spaces to encourage social interactions.
We're in the Quartier Vert of Beaubourg. There's the Centre Pompidou just right next door. And in this area, there's the speed limit is limited to only 15 kilometers per hour, which is the concept of the Quartier Vert to slow down the speed at which vehicles move. There are streets in this region which are only pedestrian. Here you can see also a Vélib station, so people are allowed to cycle. There's a seating for some restaurants. And so they've created this public space where cars are not allowed and pedestrians can move around at ease and with safety.
Alors avant, il y avait impossibilité de marcher sur les trottoirs, les vitrines étaient, la place était complètement encombrée par les camions et camionnettes des marchands, que ce soit le matin ou l'après-midi. Et puis il y avait une propreté un petit peu qui laissait à désirer, puisque le revêtement du sol était vraiment un vrai buvard. Donc tout restait vraiment bien dans le sol, c'était très très difficile à nettoyer, malgré les efforts du service de nettoiement. Voilà.
Et maintenant,
les trottoirs, sont plus larges, donc les gens circulent mieux, c'est plus facile à nettoyer, donc c'est plus propre après le marché. Il y a moins de places de stationnement, pour le commerce c'est peut-être moins bien, mais comme de toute façon c'est les camions qui les occupaient, on nous voit et les gens sont très contents.
If Paris is an example for another city, it's important that it's a clear example. So what is happening is we're taking the cars out of the city and at the same time offering a full package of transportation alternatives. We have public transportation systems that work well. We have buses, metros, the new Vélib system, the bicycles. We're making walking a much more agreeable and easy thing to do. We have taxis, which are becoming more and more socially used. And we have transport services for the elderly and the handicapped. And then we have this, Caisse Commune and L'Autopartage. L'Autopartage, that's French for car sharing. And car sharing is what we call the last nail in the coffin of old mobility. It's the one thing that, once it's in place here in Paris, much of the requirement, much of the need for having your own car will disappear altogether.
Alors, merci Denis pour ne pas être venu à Washington aujourd'hui. Et félicitations à vous et à toute votre équipe.
Merci beaucoup. Merci.
C'était tout juste après la guerre, dans un petit bal qu'avait souffert, sur une piste de misère, il y en avait deux à découvrir.